Let's think about what happens to an IS curve when government spending goes up. And to think about that, let's first draw our Keynesian cross. So on the vertical axis over here, we have aggregate expenditures. In the horizontal axis right over here, we have aggregate income. These are really just two ways of talking about GDP. And so we are thinking we actually want all of the points where the economy is in equilibrium, where income is equal to expenditures. And so that's why we draw that line of slope 1. That's all of the points where income is equal to expenditures, where our economy is in some type of equilibrium or in equilibrium. And then we think about planned expenditures. And planned expenditures, we've done this multiple times. It's equal to aggregate consumer spending, which is a function of income minus taxes, or it's a function of disposable income. And we're not saying C times Y minus T. We're saying C is a function of Y minus T. This is one way of talking about our consumption function. We assume it's linear in this video and in others, but it doesn't have to be. It could be a curve of some kind. And then we have our planned investment plus planned investment, which we're assuming that we're sitting at some, that our real interest rates are fixed right now. So planned investment plus government spending, and then we can even throw net exports out there if we assume that we have some type of an open economy. And this curve, our planned investment, this is all a review of the Keynesian cross videos, it might look something like this. And we get to our equilibrium. We get to our equilibrium level of GDP. And so we can also use this information, given that we were sitting here at interest rate R1, to start to at least plot one point, on our IS curve. So let's draw at least one point on our IS curve, and hopefully you feel good about the general shape of it. And then we could think about how the IS curve might shift. So here we have real interest rates. We're trying to relate real interest rates to aggregate GDP. So we just showed that when we're real interest rates are sitting at R1, so if this is R1 right over here, if real interest rates are sitting at R1, we know that the aggregate level of output or income is that point right over there. So we could just drop that down. And so it is this level right over here. So when real interest rates are R1, this is our output. That is a point on our IS curve. And so we can draw the entire IS curve, which might look something like that. That is our entire IS curve. If we kept changing this, if we kept trying this out for different real interest rates, we could plot more and more of these points along the IS curve. And so this is really thinking in terms of if real interest rates go up, then this whole expression will go down, then this thing will be shifted down, and so we would have less GDP. Your equilibrium, if this gets shifted down, your equilibrium GDP might go over here. So at a higher real interest rate, you would have lower aggregate income. And so that's how we actually thought about plotting our IS curve. Now, with all of that out of the way, let's think about what happens when government spending goes up. Well, if government spending goes up, if this piece right over here goes up, that will shift our planned expenditures up as well. And so your change in government spending, so change in G, it would shift this curve up. It would, let me draw that a little bit neater. It would shift this curve up, and you would get to a new level of income or equilibrium level of real GDP. And that amount, this delta Y, which is this amount right over here, it's actually going to be equal to the multiplier, which is 1 minus the marginal propensity to consume times our change in government spending. But you don't have to worry about this too much for the sake of this video. That's just a little bit of a review. But the whole reason why I'm doing this is we're saying, look, we're assuming R1 didn't change. And when we increased government spending, it shifted GDP up by that amount. So when you increased government spending, it shifted at R1, it shifted it by that amount. Well, that would be true at any of the real interest rates along the IS curve. And so in general, if you increase government spending and you're not changing any of this other stuff, then the IS curve would shift to the right. And if you decreased government spending, the IS curve would shift to the left. So with that in our toolkit now, we can think about how a change in government spending might change our equilibrium point in our ISLM model. And so let's do that. So once again, real interest rates. Here we have We have aggregate income, or real GDP. And then we have our IS curve. Our IS curve looks something like that. And our LM curve, I will do it in magenta. Our LM curve might look something like that. And so if we have an increase in government spending, we already saw the IS curve shifts to the right. I don't want to do that in the same color. So it shifts to the right, and it might look something like that. And so if our old equilibrium real interest rate was sitting here and equilibrium income was sitting here, we saw that by increasing the government spending, our new equilibrium GDP is higher, and our new equilibrium interest rate is higher, just by the shift to the IS curve. Now you might be saying, okay, Sal, you've been focusing on the IS curve, but does an increase in government spending, does it affect the LM curve? Does a change in fiscal policy, does that affect the LM curve? We're not talking about printing more money, we're talking about the government spending more, increasing its budget. Well, remember, the LM curve, it's driven by people's liquidity preferences at different levels of GDP. How much do they want to hold money, and how much would you have to pay for them in terms of interest for them to depart with it, or how much interest are they willing to pay to get access to money at different levels of GDP? So that's not really impacted by government spending. And it's also impacted by the money supply, by the amount of money that are out there and just general levels of prices. And you could start to think about, oh, well, doesn't government spending affect prices in the long run? But if we just hold a lot of those things constant, especially in the short term, especially if you hold prices constant, fiscal policy is not going to change the LM curve. Monetary policy, the money supply part, that could, or people's liquidity preferences could. But just government policy by itself, fiscal policy by itself, won't change it. So if we, in this model, just not trying to get too overcomplicated, when government spending goes up, when G goes up, it would shift the IS curve to the right, increase in real interest rates, increase in real GDP, according to this model.